The next step in ONS would be to create a question bank assignment based on the exercises we have in this overview. As you can see here, in total I have 121 exercises in my question bank. In order for me to create a question bank assignment, I need to make a smaller selection. This can either be done manually by using the filters at the top, or ONS will generate an assignment for me based on a blueprint. This option I will demonstrate later. But I will begin with the manually creating a question bank assignment method. To manually create a question bank assignment, you can use the filters here at the top. This will make the selection of the exercises smaller. So for example, I could select the labels filter and only filter on the exercises that have the label accepted. You will now see the selection is smaller. In this way, you can add multiple filters to this selection in order for ONS to give you the right exercises. The next step would be to select these exercises. This can be done by clicking on this box and navigating to More. Here you can add the exercises to an assignment. What you can do is add your exercises to an already existing assignment within your question bank, or you can create a new assignment from scratch. I will fill in a name, and ONS will then create an assignment for me and will add these 5 exercises to my assignment. This is the first method of creating a question bank assignment. The next method would be to create an assignment based on a blueprint. This is done by generating an assignment. First off, we need to go back into the objectives to go into the blueprints. The blueprint is the first step to generate a question bank assignment automatically. We will start by creating a new blueprint. And what we see here is an overview of the domains and the objectives part of my question bank. Next to the objective, you can see that there's been added a box. This means that in total, 6 questions in my question bank are tied to this learning objective. Now it's up to me to give ONS the instructions on how many of these 6 to select for my assignment. So I will change a couple of these numbers by clicking and changing the number. This way I will scroll through the domains and objectives and I search for the objectives I want to add to my assignments. It is automatically updated and saved, as you can see here on the left side. This is the first step of generating a question bank assignment. The next step would be to go back into your question bank assignments and click on Generate. Now I will give ONS the instruction to generate an assignment based on my blueprint, but I can also add some additional filters like the labels and the tags we've also done in the manual method. I will click on Generate and I will fill in some fields here. At the top, you will fill in the name of the assignment. Below, you will select the blueprint that you would like ONS to use to generate your assignment. This is the blueprint we've just created. Next to that, you will select the exercise selection. This can either be fixed or randomized per participant. Fixed means that ONS will create one version of the assignment and that all the students will be given the same exercises and same questions in the assignment. They can still be randomized, so the order could differ, but the same questions will be answered by the students. If you would like to have multiple versions of an assignment, you can also click on randomized per participant. Our advice would be to have a big enough of a question bank in order for ONS to select several versions of a question and to then distribute them among the students. This means that the students will still be taught on the same learning objectives, but this is done by answering different questions. Then one last mandatory field is the labels. Here you will tell Ans what labels Ans is allowed to select for your assignment. All of the options below are optional. So for example, you could filter on the question types. What question types would you like Ans to select for your assignment? Or here you can filter on the tags. This works in the same way as with the manual way of creating an question bank assignment. I will now click on generate, and Ans will then search through my exercises in the question bank and select the exercises that meet my criteria from the blueprint and from the criteria I have added in this page. Here you can see that Ans selected 6 exercises for me to be added in this question bank assignment. After having generated an assignment based on a blueprint or manually creating a question bank assignment based on filters, you can go into the settings of the assignment. And here you can select and edit some optional features. For example, you can edit test instructions, which will be shown before, during, or after the test to the students. You can alter the mark calculation, or you can add an attachment by clicking on New Attachment. These are all optional, so you can also edit these options when you've copied over your question bank assignment into your course, because that would be the next step. In order for students to actually take the assignment, this question bank assignment needs to be copied over to my course. In a question bank, we have no students, and it's not possible to add a time slot. So we're now gonna make the transition from the question bank, which we've also seen in the slides at the beginning, and we will now move over to the course, which we have the assignments and the students below. In the actions section, you see copy assignment to course. By copying the assignment, you select the course you would like this assignment to be copied over to. You select it here and you click on save. Now we're making the transition from the question bank to the course, and Ans is preparing the assignment to be copied over to the course. Within the course, which you can see here, we have the assignment. Within the assignment in the course, we have several steps to take in order for the students and for the instructors to finish the workflow. So we are currently in the tab Digital Test, which is the same as the digital test in the question bank, but then all the exercises are put together into one test, which can then also be previewed here on the right side. The next step would be to then schedule a time slot and monitor the taking session. After the students have submitted their results, we're gonna review the results. The results will be calculated and will be possible to be published to the students. And lastly, we will monitor and analyze the statistics automatically created by Ans. These are the remaining steps of the workflow. But first off, I will go into the settings to change some settings of this digital test, after which we can do a preview to see the assignment from the eyes of the student. In the settings, you can see the menu on the left side. If we, for example, would go to the accessibility options, we have the option to change the access or utilities the students can use during the assignment. For example, for a formative assignment, it's possible to set the multiple attempts to more. This means that the students can then access the test 3 times. It's also possible to to secure the assignment with a password. The utilities can be used by the students during the taking session. So for example, the students can take digital notes within the platform, and there is no need for paper during the taking session. It's also possible to, for example, set a calculator, basic or scientific. And at the bottom, you have some options to set the navigation of the students within the assignment. In this overview, you also have the option to select integrations. The integrations first need to be configured on institution level by the administrators. After that, you can then enable them in the assignment in the integrations. For now, we will move back into the digital test and do the preview of the test, which can be done here. Here we can see the steps the students will take during the assignment taking session. This is the first screen the student will see. By clicking on Start, the timer of the test will then start ticking. This is the first exercise with one question in this test. Per page in the assignment, we add only one exercise. So for example, this is exercise one. And if you can then use the tiles at the bottom or you use the arrows at the right side of the screen, you can navigate to the next exercise. As you can see here, we have multiple questions A, B, and C on one page. And the student can then fill in some answers in this way. Students can also use the bookmark here at the top. This is a way for them to indicate that it could be necessary for them to go back into this question in a later stage. So the student then sees this orange button here. And in this way, they know that after going through all of the questions, they need to go back to question 2A because perhaps they're not sure about the answer yet. Additionally, on the top right side of the screen, we have the calculator, which we've enabled in the test settings. And also the digital notes can then be added here. Next to that, we also have the settings. These settings are aimed for the students. So it could be that students would like to use a large font or, for example, a high contrast mode during the taking session. In this way, as you can see at the background of the screen, the test is automatically updated in a large font and high contrast mode. These settings are aimed at the students. These cannot be edited by the teacher or an admin. Also, if I have enabled the high contrast mode as a student and click on close, I can then go through this assignment with these settings. And the next time I will sign in to ANS and take another assignment, the same settings are applied. This is because they've been saved in my personal account. Whenever the student is finished with going through all of the questions, they can use this button to submit the test. At the top, you will see a notification if you have any unanswered questions, and this could mean that you have to go back into your assignment. If you're ready to submit your test, you can confirm to submit and click on submit. This was the preview of how the test will look like for a student. I will now close the preview to go back into the editing mode of my assignment.